Hi there, my name is Ross, and you're watching a brand new Web Dev King video tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you on how you can work with cookies using HTML and JavaScript. Alright, so this is a very basic tutorial just to give you an understanding on how cookies work. As you can see, I have a text box that says test. I press create cookie, and it says first cookie value equals test. Now, I can get cookie value, so I click on get cookie. And it says get cookie value is test, and I can also delete the cookie, click on it, and it will come up as undefined. How do we do this? Well, it's rather simple on how you create a cookie. It's not complicated. As you can see here, we've got a very simple structure. It's a HTML5 document, and you might be going, how can I tell it's a HTML5 document? All the new HTML5 documents since 2012 uses doctype.html with the exclamation mark at the start of it. So that tells me this web page is ready to go. You might notice these two script tags right here. They're actually loading an external JavaScript file. This one is actually hosted on the Google API website, and it's actually a jQuery library 3.3.1. You do require jQuery for this route, so just bear that in mind. I'm also using another plugin as well called jscookie.min.js, and I'm just using their CDN, which they provided me. I'll also drop a link in the description on where you can get these files, and I'll also include a copen of this document. As you can see, we have some variables. This is practically pretty basic variables. We're just grabbing all of these HTML elements down here, and we're just renaming them practically. That's all a variable is. The first thing I did was I created a button called create with a basic link flick function in jQuery. And the first thing you notice is I'm using cookies to define what this line of code does. So I said cookies.set, and this first value is the name of the cookie, okay? So when you are setting a brand new cookie, it will require you to have two arguments that it needs to pass through. So in this instance, it's grabbing the value of this text box down at the bottom. Now, the next line of code is an alert saying cookie value is cookie val. Now, cookie val is a variable, and I'm using cookies.get. Now, cookies.get only has one argument, and that is the name of the cookie. Okay, so that's what it says here, first-cookie. That's the name of it. If you want to remove a cookie, you can do so by using the remove command, and that only has one argument as well. At the end of the day, when you are programming and when you are working on big projects, my advice to you is to keep things simple. If you found this video tutorial helpful, be sure to subscribe, like, rate, and comment, and let me know what you want me to do next. Thanks for watching.